Thanks, Stevie Ray, and we're back. It's a new four-part series. I've already got a few tables up because I wanted to jump into a few different stages of the game. The top left is a 55 freeze, top right's $4 rebuy, bottom right's PLO, which I don't really know how to play, but I kind of just did it for fun, so I'll actually swap that guy out. I'll replace it with this $5 rebuy. Actually, if I get deep in the PLO, I guess deep, there's only like 20 people in it. If I get a stack in the PLO one, I'll bring it up just for kicks. Why not? Yesterday I had a pretty good day. Came second in the 162 on lock, third in the 100, a couple other caches on merge. Pretty excited about it. First good day I've had in a long time. These tournaments on Lock Poker, you generally only pay out the top four or five people, so it can be pretty brutal when you go 5 or 6 days without a cash. It's been happening to me. I'm actually getting crushed on this site, but there's plenty of time to rebound. 7-6 suited appears as an easy call. It's the $5 rebuy, so I'm going to be calling off my stack way more than I'm going to be raising it off in the first levels, in the rebuy period. And pair of sixes here is pretty damn good, considering it's the rebuy. Nice little half pot. Should take it down. Short stacked up here in the 55. Played like an idiot, mostly. But it happens. Happens to the best of us. A lot of regs here. AZN all in. Little TP reg right there. Hopefully I can get in some good hands versus him on the better side of it too. $4 rebuy. It's pretty solid. The add-on's going to be in about 2 minutes. Should be kind of nice playing pre-add-on and a post-add-on at the same time. Makes for some vids. Good vids. Hopefully I can make this four-part series, depending on how good the content is. I wish I had recorded yesterday. That was, you know, would have made great content, but can't always pick your days right. My 5-4, this guy limps under the gun. He could have a middle pair or something, but my hand's good enough where a shove is fine here. It could look stronger, and yeah, you know, I'm just going to check raise. This looks a bit stronger. Maybe he'll fold sevens. Yeah, probably won't, but I'm never folding here. This just looks a little bit stronger. And my hand is pretty good still. I mean, top pair, open-end draw. Not really ever behind many hands. Straight's good. Surprised he just called there and then folded. I really don't know what he was drawing to. Maybe he had an ace high. Maybe, I don't know. And had the five as a draw as well. $30 deep stack. I open a ton of hands. Ace 7 suited's good. I'm not going to go nuts with it either. I'm just going to try to hit big and then fold. But no. Jack 9. 120 chips into 440. It's good enough. I know that Arthur is probably going to call most of the time. So I don't mind the flat here. AZN's range is pretty tight under the gun. So the fact that he doesn't c-bet tells me he doesn't have aces or kings or queens. Unless he's going to, if he calls here, that'd be sick. A7 flop good there. Play pretty straightforward. A6 on the button, suited, easy raise, 2.5x, 2x, 3x, pretty much whatever you want, doesn't matter. Just I'm c-betting the swap every time. Half pot. I think depending on how often you raise should be how you open your bets pre-flop. Like, if you don't raise very often, I think your raises should be more. But if you're raising, like, I towards the end just raise every single hand. So my raises pre-flop should just be min bets because I raise so often. But if I was only raising like 5% of hands, I think that it would be 3 or 4xing pre-flop, which I don't encourage. Obviously, play more hands. Oh, I'm going to bet my jack for value here. You might call me with 8s or 9s, 10s, 7s. And he folds. King 7 deuce, very dry flop. C-bet. Take this down most of the time. I think they need a hand here to defend. You got it, Oprah. Good for you. I mean, I don't think Oprah's ever bluffing there. And down to 19 big blinds, pre-ante, so I'm not going to be reshoving as light as people think. Think hands that I would normally reshove pre-flop right now with antes would be hands like King-Jack and King-10 suited, but I'll take out the bottom of my range now just because there are no antes, so I won't be reshoving a hand like 5s, 6s, maybe not even King-Queen. If it's late, if it's like button, big blind, that stuff, I'll reshove those hands, but I'm not going to be restuffing an under the gun open. I think people get too carried away when they get short early and they think that it's just time to gamble it up. It's actually a better time to knit it up because you're going to be getting called lighter and it's cheaper. You don't have to pay antes. Jack's just standard raise. Been very active, so there's a chance I get 3-bet. And I'm obviously committed. I'm never folding. I don't think I've ever folded Jack's pre-flop in my life. It's not true, I have. So, take it down. Alright, I'm gonna raise fold these sevens. I know I have under 20 bigs, but I don't mind. I mean I've switched up the whole raise folding thing under 20 bigs now, depending on the stacks and everything. I think it's okay to raise fold sometimes under 20 bigs. I think the game has changed a bit. I mean, back in the past I would never have raise folded under 20 bigs, but the game is consistently changing and the biggest edge you're going to find is playing the very small spots a little bit better. Just doing small things, bet sizing, so. So not much action right now. Hopefully things will pick up in a bit. Weeways is sitting out, it's nice. Kings versus tens. It's really the top of Hobo Lobo's range. He just got it in really bad before. And again, he does. He gets there. It's actually really good because he's one of the weaker players at the table. Or at least from what I've seen. This, I don't know if he's actually bad, but from what I've seen this tournament so far, he's been gambling in spots he shouldn't have been. Oh, and Arthur folded JJ. That's great. So Oprah, I don't want to defend here. Oprah's, he's a reg, so I mean, there's not really much of a point of defending 7-9 offsuit. So shallow stacked, just let him have it. I'm not gonna c-bet this King-Queen. There's no need. 9-6, fold. Kibotsky's a knit. See, King-10, oh, it's suited. I probably wouldn't have folded the King-10, but you could make, if it was offsuit, I definitely would have, just because K-Bot is such a knit. Like, most of the time, the shoving range has a king in it. And we run out of straight. in the $30 deep stack. I'm gonna open just about every button. Just because these guys aren't gonna just squeeze with any two. Not a bad flop. Yeah, all right, Arthur, you got it. Trying to think of hands he leads there. He leads an ace. It's the board's pretty draw heavy, so I think he has to lead out a lot of his good cards. Unless he thinks I'm going to c-bet 100% of the time, where I usually do, but I don't think this guy knows really who I am, so he's just going to lead out with his value hands there. And his value hands beat my hand. I mean, even if he's defending like king queen there, it's good. Alright, just pick on this guy sitting out. Play ace jack suited, even though I wanted him to play. Oh, I'm going to c-bet ace jack here all day. Some draws on board, I don't really mind. Hand's still pretty good. He's calling me with hands like Jack 10. I'm going to make my bet sizing a little bit bigger now. It's obviously a good river. And I'm going to bet pretty big for value here. And he folds, which makes me think he just had diamonds. Because I think a queen calls there. Oh, he could have had bottom pair. That's pretty bad. My standard. Come on, Kabotsky. Get it in. Okay, that's good. Decent flop. And I bet this small. I would bet it like this small, too, if I didn't have a hand. Just flat. If he's bluffing hard, so let him bluff it off. Although I don't think he's ever folding. Oh, just a set. No good, sir. Sorry, your set's lower than my set. Must be nice to run like me today. Even though set over set and I'm at starting stack. Good job. Alright, so I haven't busted out of a tournament yet. And I got some double stacks and other tourneys. This is great. It's a great start to making bids. And the guy to my direct left in the $5 rebuy sitting out doesn't get much better than that. And I just doubled in the Omaha tourney. Things are looking up. Hopefully I'll be able to bring that one out when it gets down to it. Yeah, 15 peeps left. My ace nine is literally never good here. I mean, that's pretty obvious. I'm just trying to see what AZN has. I think the very bottom of AZN's range right here is queens and ace king. So we'll find out. I mean, I would even be surprised if he had jacks here. I'd be really surprised. I don't have any stats up on Lenny right now, so that probably plays into it. I don't know if he does, but I would assume he's got... Wow, this guy folded queens! Oh my god. I don't know if you can 3-bet fold queens there. Maybe you can. I guess if he never has jacks, then you can. Wow, that's sick. That's so sick. Did you have it? This is great. He's probably not going to respawn. He's on tables. All right, Oprah, what do you have? Ace king. Yeah, this makes sense. Opening is 5-8 here. It's 30 chips for free. And this guy's gonna fold to a ton of c-bets. Just half pot it. If we were deeper, I wouldn't make it half pot. I would do like a third or a quarter pot. Just the board's so dry, and a deuce is really never in his hand. So it's an easy pot to win post flop. Most of the time, if he actually continues, he has a hand. Len says, I just didn't want to race for half my stack. Agree with that. Ace 5 suited. Normally I would 3-bet this, but Azian's on the pretty tight side before Antes. Just flat here, try to see post flop. It's not so bad of a flop. I might be able to check raise this. If Azian continues, he has a hand. This is a pretty scary board for him to see bet. Yeah, he probably has a hand. Just get out of the way here. Don't know if that's 9 is good for him or not. I know he would be c-betting 2 overs with the flush draw. I doubt he c-bets an ace-king there or like an ace-jack. The 9 is actually, if he has an over pair, it's pretty bad for him, but it allows him to let sugar-coated bluff more often and try to rep the 9, even though I don't think he has a 9. He's saying I'm just going to give up here. Ace 9 is an easy open. Wow. I think this is a blocker bet right here. A blocker bet with value, though. Let's see if he. Wow. That's sick. I mean, I thought it was a blocker bet with value for sure. Can't believe he gets in a dispute with sevens like that. Flop set. It's nice. That's pretty bad by sugarcoated, but I still think that was a blocker bet by Mark. Blocker bet never folds. So sugarcoated is kind of a spew. I don't know. I mean, he may have thought as well that that was a blocker bet and you could get him to fold. I guess. 9-10 suited. It's just too much. Thought a little bit deeper, I'd 3-bet. Like, this is the only hand, like, stack size. I can't really do much with this hand, so I'm just going to fold. Pretty nitty, but whatever. 408 grinder. This is an easy 3-bet. The big blind's sitting out. My hand's pretty good. If he gets, let's see if he gets creative and just 4-bets me. I don't know if he will, though. If he's capable. It's like flats. It's pretty good flop for me. Can't imagine a 7-deuce-deuce is good for him. 7-7 news. And my small C bet takes it down. Nice. Ace 10's a really good hand to 3 bet pre-flop. Lets you know where you're at. Flop's okay sometimes. Lenny is still going on about his queen's fold. Alright, we get it. It's a good fold, I think. The more I think about it, the better of a fold I think it was. Especially with his chip stack. If he had like 3K in open like that, I wouldn't have liked it. But since he has a double stack, I think it's fine. Fine fold. I'm under 20 bigs now. Still going to steal. I don't need. Like, I'm not going to call a 3-bet or an all-in. I'm just going to raise as a steal, but. This flop's pretty good, so. Like, I wouldn't raise, like, 4 or 5 suited here with my stack, but Queen 10, if I ever do get flat, it does play well post flop. So, I think that the hands you should steal with are very specific when you have 20 or. You know, 15 to 20 big blind stack, just because. At this point in the tourney, I'm going to get flatted by a good amount of hands. I don't really think Wise Woman has a hand here. Let's find out. That 9 connects a lot of hands, but I still don't think it. Obviously, that's a good river. If he has King Jack, it's just, well, it's the pits. And what did wise women have? Queen Deuce. Well, sometimes you just gotta get lucky. I don't think I can get anyone to fold here with the pot size bet. Put it at 150. Yeah, no one's gonna fold, so I'm just gonna set my own jacks. Fold my 7. Alright, obviously that's a good flop for jacks. I'm glad I set mine. Now I look like a genius. I was actually full house mining, and I got there. Come on, Pokerevel. Take a stab. Oh, that's great. I'm going to now put some pressure on the one if he has a draw. I like betting here because if he's on a draw and this guy has an 8 or something, he can repop it. And he's already forced to call. So the pot's bloated now if he has a draw. So I'm gonna bet. Yeah, I could have let him bet that river, I guess. But the hands he's betting on the river for value, I don't really put any in his range. There's really, yeah, so I should have just checked, let him bet it. Because he pretty much has, well, no, actually, I take that back. He's never betting a hand for value on the river there, so betting is better. Because he can still bluff if I lead into him. Maybe I should have made it smaller, like 200. I think a 200 bet would have been optimal because it allows him to bluff the river as a crazy play. And it allows him to call off with hands of less value. But he's never value betting the river, so I have to bet either way. Ace is probably good. People never flop flushes against me. So the reason I said he's never betting hands there for value is because since I had the top boat, the pocket jacks, he never has a jack in his hand, and he never has queens or kings or aces because he didn't raise pre-flop, so all the hands that would be value are like under pairs and no straights or flushes were out there. So it's pretty straightforward. He's 3 under the gun, fold. Queens, wow. I don't have stats on this guy, PWR. For some reason, my HUD's all off. I'm just going to jam, though. Hopefully he has jacks. And he's aces, it's great. Queen, though. 6, queen. Ah. Well, if there's any tournament to bust, it's the $4 rebuy. Still have a good hand now, though. I've made comebacks from less. And if I bust this, I get to put up the PLO table. Win-win. Induces fold. Bah, get off me, Mark. Ace Jack's an easy shove. Well, I mean, this guy's min raise. I don't even know what that's doing. I assume he's never folding. Wow, that's pretty terrible that he would min raise fold there. I mean, if he's had a hand like 5-6, he's still getting the correct odds to call. What? I like it. Pretty much double up. Without seeing a hand. Without seeing a flop. And I'm going to shove this 10-7 if it folds to me. It's 9 big blinds. Blind versus blinds. It's fine. Trying to think of Hobo Lobo's limping range. He's trying to hit pretty hard here. This is bad for me. This 6-7-8. Think it nuts his limping range, and plus there's the big blind to deal with. K5s, let's go. Ten. is. And so, sorry. And raise my fives. See what happens. Four, seven. I'm going to open this under the gun. They don't ever put me on 4-7. It's a bad flop for his defending range. I think he defends a lot of nines, jacks, queens, tens. So, pretty much, I can't win this pot. I'll c-bet my 4-7 suited. You got it, Arthur. Really thinking out of that. But we still have chips. It's all good. I'm just going to give up if Garmu does anything with this hand. He doesn't, which is nice. Ice 4. Wow. 10 plus 7, 17 bigs. I'm just going to stuff this. Don't want to get flatted. Doesn't play post well enough. This is really like borderline shove. The more I think about it, the less I like it, but there are antes involved now, so can't be the worst. Just gotta get through Oprah. Tell me this isn't an insta shove on the big blinds, sitting out. The dude. Does he isolate on the button a lot? I don't have enough hands on him. Only 25. I'll let the queen nine go. I 3-bet there a lot, though. Queen nine's decent hand, 3-bet. Ah, 6-8 would have played well too with a roll in. Little pair. Couple backdoor draws. Not anymore. Garner, Gamer UA. Still pre add on, so. I don't really, 9-5 suited, I like the hand, but for some reason I just think he's going all in there, and I don't know, I'd have to flop pretty big, not playing deep enough. Whew. Yeah, put on a pot of coffee on break. A little tired. 4-5 off suit's not good enough to shove. When I do get called by lower pairs, I'm just crushed. I'm going to flat this king 7 suited, try to flop good. I don't flop good. Checks me though, I'll bet it. So there are plenty of tournaments coming up in a half hour. There's a 150, in an hour and a half, there's 100. I'm only going to be doing lock videos on this. Queen 5-4 flops, good c-bet. Don't really think it connects many hands. If they do have a 7-6, it's hard for them to check raise. It's a good turn. I'm going to bet this again. I think he has a drawing hand right now. And then also just betting this on the turn makes him think that I'm going to bet the river. So if he has a queen, I can check it back. Damn. Ugh. That looks like a value bet if I've ever seen one. Ross, I don't think he's turning 7-6 into a bluff, so good hand. Sick if he was. Jacks, I'm going to induce here. don't mind a shove either with jacks, but it plays good enough post flop where I don't mind inducing either. Takes it down, back to starting stack. Man, I think I played one hand in this. Oh, we got a $20 freeze out coming up. I'll slide that off the screen. When I bust one of these other ones, I'll put it up. This $300 guaranteed PLO. I don't think I've played one hand, and I'm at the final table with eight left. I mean, only five people pay, but it's pretty funny. We've literally played one hand. C-bet this flop all day. Very dry flop. It's going to take him a hand to continue. I can always improve on the turn, too. Nice or jack. I mean, I can't always put him on a king there. Aces, this is what we're going to do. We're going to misclick. We're going to misclick it. Come on, everyone, come on for the ride. Ace 9 easy shove up there. Hopefully someone thinks I messed up here. I like doing this. All it has to do is if it works like one out of like 20 times, it's good enough. I think. Yeah, look, he just Ross G's shoves. I'm going to fold that. It's a snap call. You see if he has kings. Ace king. Okay, fade the hearts. So far, so good. Oh, no. Nice. Makes it 1,800 and gets action. Wow. Ross G. How bad can I run? Oh, man. Sorry, Ross. Misclick. Sorry. He's heated. Queen 9 suited. I'm going to min-raise fold this. I min-raise fold because Artur has a very small 3-bet. I think 3-bet's big out of the big blind. I probably should have known that first. Len has a big 3-bet, but I think it takes him a good hand to 3-bet here. So I don't mind the 3-bet fold. I don't know. People may say it's bad, but I don't think it's too bad. Would I have 15 bigs? It's a tough flop for Curtis to continue on. So I think I get him to fold his better queens and jacks. Now I'm just going to shove this king-queen here. A lot of times I would shove that queen nine suited, but I just think some spots it's fine to, it like looks so strong that they have to have a good hand sometimes to get it in. Fourteen bigs, 10-9 suited. Let's go. Weeways, sorry, dude, you're crushed. Queens are good. Hold. Oh my god, look at that. I get cocky for a second. We flop good. Nice little $5 rebuy. King Jack's a stuff here. Just playing so short, I gotta gamble no matter what. Probably a small pair, like sevens. I think he has sixers or sevens. Or ace eight suited. I guess that's a good trap. Smoky. This guy does open a ton under the gun, but his 4.2x says he's not going to fold. So I'd have to be shoving sixes for value. And I think that a lot of mid pairs like jacks and tens are in his opening range right there for that bet size. Five eight offsuit. These guys have big stacks and they play a good amount out of the big blinds. Oh, my stats are all off. Game two easy does. I don't know where Bubba's are. I'm just gonna fold it. and try to repop up this HUD. My HUD's been off lately. I really don't know what to do about it. It's kind of frustrating, but what can I do? Just gotta roll with the punches. Oh, table talk. Maverick plays Nitty. I'm gonna min 3-bet this because I think he's gonna fold to a lot of c-bets post-flop, and he's never capable of 4-betting light. So if he 4-bets, he has it. Whatever, I pay 240 chips to find out where I'm at. So, like, this flop right here, I think he's gonna fold to a ton of c-bets. And I can always improve. Nice, he folded. So I don't mind the min 3-bet versus Nitz. It's kind of a good strat. I've actually been talking to people about it recently, and everyone seems to have a different opinion, which isn't always a bad thing. Sixes hold. Oh, wait, no, they don't. Sixes do not hold. Yeah, queens, let's go. I'm a luck sack. I don't think that's the real I'm a luck sack. But 8-4 is just not good enough to defend. Come on, someone open. Heshikon. The luck people have. Sick. Thanks, Bubba Cake. I'm going to induce here. Induce from game two easy. Again, your opening bet sizing should be based on the amount of times that you raise pre-flop. And always pre-antes, you should be betting more. And raise and deuce again. The king jack, I'm just going to fold. I have double stack. It's fine. Got a sick hand in this Omaha right now. Just bring this up for the sweat. Ross is pretty tight. I'm not going to mess with him. Aces versus 8-7, deuce 3. I do not have the club draw. I think I chop that. I do chop it. Nice. All right. Sorry, I'll take that off. I think I just took down the jacks pre-flop. Had to... Sorry, I was just reading the chat when I said misclick with aces. Obviously, you knew I was full of it. It's easy game. Aces versus ace king. I don't know. Maybe he could have folded the ace king suited there. You know, like, it's not like I do that often. I don't know. I'm just trying to play this game and run good, that's all. I think I'm on the stone bubble of this $10 PLO. Kind of fun. Easy end, open under the gun. He only opens up 13% of hands. I don't have, well, a lot of these stats are from double or nothings. So, it's kind of different. Like, I don't really know his true stats. But, obviously, if he was playing, if I played thousands of hands with him in double or nothings, like, he's going to look like the biggest nit of all time when in MTTs he's definitely not. So, I mean, I really don't know what this is, if he's light or if he's strong. Given that it's post-Annie's, I'm leaning towards the light side. Oof. Gonna see bet this. I don't think he can really continue with much, so he has a hand. Yeah, give up. My seven deuce. I still have almost a double stack in the five rebuy. You know, once you get to the double stack, you have to calm down a bit. I think Mark c-bet that flop. And now it's, I don't know what he's going to do on the turn. That's kind of a blank. I mean, if you open a hand like 9-10 suited or something under the gun, it wouldn't be. But it's pretty much blank. Oh, I mean, beat Shylala could have ace jack here. Nine ten. Oh, he has ace jack. Hold. Nice hand, Mark. I hate that line with 9-10. I absolutely I hate it because it'd be different. He doesn't even have like an over, so he's pretty much anytime he's getting called, he's just crushed. And with one pull, he's drawn to a straight. What is that, like 15% or something? I don't even know. I know it's bad though. I mean, the check raise on the turn does look super strong, but Mark has enough chips where he can gamble, or did. My ace deuce. Ah, the nine's a bad card. If he pots this, I gotta fold. That's sick. That's literally the worst card on the river. Makes up a ton of two pairs, straights, etc. You got it. If he had a half pot, I'd probably call. And it looks like I'm in the money in this PLL. Ship that. Ace four. This guy 5x. It says he's never folding. Fold. Ugh. This is so nitty, but I have to fold. Kurt is such a nit. I don't think King Queen's good. Suited two clubs, my God. I'll find a spot though. I think this is a pretty good spot. I don't know if I should min raise or shove. I'm going to just shove because I would shove every hand that I like. I think a min raise has to be the nuts. Ugh. You know, sometimes I overthink hands and I feel like the min raise is too obvious, but maybe with the players at this table, a min raise just isn't that obvious. Either way, though, win the hand, pick up some necessary blinds. It's not the worst thing in the world. All right, I'm going to take this $5 rebuy out of here just for a second, pull up the PLO because it's final table. It's down to four people. It's a bit more fun. And it won't last very long. It's Jack 7's a fold, sitting 15 bigs, 14. Just gonna play shove fold for the most part. Jacks, I'm gonna pot this, get it in. I think Jacks on the button's good enough. My stack. Just shows you I have absolutely no idea how to play PLO. I've been playing super nit though, like I've only played two hands and I won both of them. So that was nice. Ace King 3-5, decent hand. Do the same. If I were sitting a little bit bigger, I'd probably just min raise. I feel like pot's fine. Showing that I'm never folding. that's kind of a bad flop though. Just check it. No draws, nothing. So I have it your way. And I've just busted out of the 23s. It's like, okay, ace five is a shove here. Ugh, I don't understand these guys. This bet is like 4x. I mean, do I have fold equity? I think I do, which is why I'm shoving, but I like don't like this at all. I don't like this at all, but I think I have fold equity here. What is he 4xing? He calls him as ace deuce. If this guy folds, I'm like shocked. I'm gonna ship this king jack here. Don't have many chips. Wow, queen three, you're the worst. Ace. No four, no queen. That's all I gotta face. Two cards. Ship it. That was sick. I don't understand why he wouldn't just jam. Oh, I'm going to call. I'm not going to call this. They sport suited. I was trying to hit a monster. I didn't. So be it. I don't want to min raise and then have to fold. So I think. And he can't really ever. No one can be bluffing in this spot. So I like just flatting. And I like hitting a 10 on the turn. Come on, 10 on the river. Boom. Let's go. Let's go. Chipping up nicely. Like a boss. Got another 10 minutes left on this video. It's been pretty solid right now. Just winning everything. just knit it up, I guess, in PLO. Why not? Let's see. What if I knit it up, I could get another $8. $7.80. Oh, kings, let's go. Come on, boys. Don't whoop the fish. Liquid Soul wants some. I wish I had an ace blocker right now. Don't know. Okay, it's a decent flop. It's a good flop for me to bust on. Ace 9. Game too easy. See, I think the min raise under the gun at this stage is pretty light. So I'm going to 3-bet it. Oh, no, 8 or 7. Look at that. Kings are good. See, the good thing about PLO is that nobody else knows how to play this. So the fact that I don't know how to play and they don't know how to play, I think I got a little edge there. I don't know what this guy would flat and then flat again. I wonder if ace jack or ace queen's in his range. I think it is, but we're going to find out right now. Yeah, that's bad. I really think he has like an ace jack. There are no draws out there. There are no draws. I'm just going to fold here. Nice hand. Not hand. Liquid squid. I'm going to stop this. I have fold equity on everyone. Maybe not Weeways. I probably should have noticed that first. But whatever. Let's gamble. Let's gamble. Ace 10 and King Queen. Doesn't make much sense, but we can turn Jack. Oh, that's good. Oh, I like brick out on that card. Alright, GG in the 4 rebuy. Bring back the 5 rebuy, which I got 9k chips. I chipped up a bit in it. I got it. I should probably review that ace nine hand. I mean, I don't mind the 3-bet. Actually, don't mind it too much as played. I got pretty much the nuts up here in the $10 plow. Pot, pot it. Go. He has. Oh, I got him crushed. That's good. It's a great plow. Oh, that's a bad turn. Well, that's too bad. Adam absolutely dominated. You know, it'd just be so nice to ship a PLO. Turn the on bid. Now I'm just going to go back to the luck game. Wow, I had him dominated. That is the worst flop ever. Oh, that's the worst. Can I fold this? I've already put in half my stack. I don't even know. All right, let's go. Fold, fold, liquid squid. Liquid soul. Oh my god, he folded the nuts. He didn't know I only had one. I was drawing to one card. What a fish. What a fish. Even an ace walker. What a fish. When he jammed that pre. Queen deuce, I can come in for 125 into 800. Easily good enough odds, even though it's a shit hand. Decent flop for my ace four. Let's see about this. Oh, I'm folding. All right, bro. What you got, sir? This looks so nutty, this raise. Snapped at it too. I think it looks even stronger. My ace queen 10 is not that good here. Yeah, bro. Try to get all out of line. That's what happens. Couple of aces in the plow. Oh, you're getting it, MMG. Decent claw. Watch him call now with like jacks. Oh my god, that would be too funny if he called me with jacks. Queens. He's pretty much dead to running hearts. Wait, did he just chop a straight there? Oh my god, we just chopped. That's so terrible. Running bad in PLO. Running bad. Damn, that's beat, Jeff. Sorry, man. Hey, man. All good. $10 buy-in. Ace Queen's an easy raise. Oh, flop good. I'm going to c-bet this and call off Len. Hope he doesn't have a king. It's really the only thing I'm dead to. Yeah. Spade, though. Eight. Spade. Spade, let's go. Chipping up. Carnival. Do you have a deuce seven or five? I doubt it. I'm just gonna start min raising now a ton in this 50 freeze. God, if I get a heads up with Mark, this would be awesome. I think he's still in it. Let's see where he's at. AZN all in. 10K, how about you catch up, bud? How about you do that? I'm a Luxack, has never 3-bet me before. This 3-bet is small. It's the only thing that concerns me, is I think a small 3-bet out of position is most likely the not that good of a hand. But his stack size says that it's just tough with the stack size. I'll play Nit and just give this up, just because he's never 3-bet me before. All right, looks like we are on break, so that will do it for the first vid, and I'll be back for a new one.